guys, welcome back to the channel. And so for those of you who do not know, I have pets, and a lot of pets. So as you can see, I have many tanks, and I have a variety of animals I care from reptiles to my massive Amazon community tank to some leopard geckos over here. But out of all of these, I have one fish in this room that stands out to most everyone, and that would be my pet largemouth bass. And so this is a very iconic fish. If you show a picture of a largemouth bass to anyone, almost guarantee you they'll know what it is, whether you're a avid fisherman or you've just walked into a Walmart and seen fishing rods advertised for bass. Bass are everywhere and one of the most popular fish on the planet, but they hardly get any aquarium attention, and that is something I want to change and shine light on, how to keep your very own baby largemouth bass like my guy here. The first thing you should know about largemouth bass is they love food, and they eat a lot of food. And my friend here has been chasing me all day looking for food, so let's go ahead and feed him some food. All right, so let's get into some feeding, and here's some slow motion of him destroying his food. So for those of you wondering, he has a variety of foods I feed him. He usually gets crickets every other day, and I feed him these shrimp pellets, which are basically ground up shrimp, every day. He gets a variety of these, and the ones he doesn't eat sink down to the bottom and feed my channel catfish, who also lives in this tank, but he does not come out as much because, as you may know, channel catfish are very skittish bottom feeders. So, as I mentioned, he also eats crickets, worms, and a variety of feeder insects, and so let's quickly throw some in, and just like that, it's gone in slow motion on this one so we can see it better. Otherwise, I promise you, you would have not seen that. He's just crushing it with his jaws, and let's feed him another one. He's already back up for more. Let's feed him one in normal speed now. Bam, gone, so fast. Let's throw in another cricket slow motion. I am sure he'll eat this. And just go. Alright, so he has eaten three crickets and a very large pinch of shrimp pellets. Despite what he has to say, and the fact that I think he definitely wants to say otherwise, he is done for food for the night. So let's get into his tank setup. Alright, so now let's move into some of his tank setup. Over here, I use a sponge filter rated for approximately 30 gallons for this tank. They need a lot of oxygen flow, and it's good to use a sponge filter bigger than the tank, especially because bass are very messy fish, and I don't think a small sponge filter would keep up with this. You can also use any other sort of filter, canister filter, hang-on back filter, suction cup filter, sponge filter, it doesn't matter, as long as it provides a significant amount of oxygen. Now for lighting, I simply bought a desk lamp and it works perfectly and I have not had any problems. And I would always recommend adding substrate for any fish and a log that he can hide under. And over here I have just a little slab because my channel catfish lives in here too. You can do real plants. I just have fake plants in here because when I put live plants in, someone in here ate them. And that someone would be you, because I think I have the most aggressive bass on the planet. The filter pushes the plant and he thinks he should attack it. He ate all of my floater plants I put in here to try to keep the water cleaner. He will eat everything that moves. And this brings me to something very sad. If you follow the channel, you know that I used to have a pet bluegill that lived with my bass, and the other day my bass decided that the bluegill needed to be food, and I was only gone for one night, and in that one night period he decided to attack and kill my bluegill. So very sad, and I will miss my little pet bluegill, and just goes to show, if you're keeping fish with your bass, they better be pretty darn big. His bluegill wasn't even that much smaller than him. He certainly couldn't even fit it in his mouth, although he somehow ripped the tail off and ate that. So, as my bass is begging for more food, look who decided to come out. It's Whiskers, my channel catfish who I was telling you about. He decided to come and scavenge the bat food that my bass did not eat, and is gobbling that up over here. So, for those of you who are wondering, that's what Whiskers looks like. So let's get into tank size. For a juvenile, you can even keep them in a tank as small as a 5 gallon is a little fry. When they first hatch, they can be very tiny. I would recommend very quickly moving them into a 10 gallon, which would last them a little over half a year before they need an even bigger tank. And for that even bigger tank, will last them quite a lot longer. All right, so for an adult largemouth bass, I would recommend a very large tank. You can probably get away with a 150 gallon, although I would definitely recommend going up closer to 200 to 300, although it will take a while for your bass to reach this size. They are not exactly very fast at growing in captivity compared to some other species of fish. To prove that for you, this guy right here I've had for about half a year, and he hasn't needed to upgrade from this tank once yet. Although he's definitely getting close to where he probably will. So now that you know all of your care facts on largemouth bass, how do you get a largemouth bass? There are a variety of different ways, and the main two are you can either buy one from a local pet store, or you can go out and catch one. Largemouth bass that are about 3 to 4 inches usually retail between $20 to $25. However, if you are purchasing a smaller one, it would be less, and a bigger one, it would be more, obviously. Okay, so catching your very own largemouth bass is very easy to do. During the spring, they breed and spawn along the edges of lakes, rivers, streams, ponds, wherever you locally have bass. And catching them is very easy. The one disclaimer is it can be illegal in some areas to capture local game fish that are under a certain size, which makes some areas very unlikely that you will be able to take a largemouth bass from. Now that's the end of the video. Thanks for watching. Remember, don't just take my word for largemouth bass. Do research. This is a serious commitment of a fish. They can get very large and very difficult to care for at times. But if you're in the market, a bass might be a perfect fish for you. So please remember to like and subscribe, and see you in the next adventure. Stay tuned for the animal adventure this weekend, and see what happened. Thank you.